He's already 98% and with 62 kilometers. So this is roughly 20 kilometers. Now in a perfect mode, so eco, side one limited to I think 30 kilometers per hour or whatever, his range should be somewhere between the 60 and the 70 kilometers. But this is sport mode. 47, 48 downhill, 45, 46 most of the time. So we're gonna eat battery life. There was another 2% just now. The question is, are we gonna get that 20 kilometers? Or I'm gonna have to walk the last bit. I think I should have taken the that part here. Oops, I'm sorry. Now obviously the Google Maps is on bicycle, because I'm not quite sure of the last part in Dordrecht. But it gave me like an hour and 20 minutes, so I decided, yeah, 55 minutes should be enough. I have 40. Which in theory probably still should be enough. But normally with my motorcycle it's 22 minutes roughly, depending on traffic lights and stuff like that. Oh, there was my shoe on the ground. So yeah, why am I doing this? I'm not quite sure if I can make it percentage wise. I'm not sure if I can make it time wise. Well, this is the best test, right? Just take it. Oh, that's cold. Yeah, now my glasses are fogging up a little bit, so better. But yeah, this is the best field test there is. Can I take the Soco, the scooter version from Rotterdam to Dordrecht? Probably not if I'm doing all these extra miles, but I think honestly I should be on the bicycle lane somewhere at this point, but for sure at the next roundabout. The good thing is legal speed everywhere. I cannot go too fast almost everywhere. I can go too fast on 30 kilometers road. So technically what I'm doing now should not be legal, I think. But when I go in here, it is legal again. So yeah, car is not allowed to go straight, but I am. Motorcycle is also not allowed to go straight, but I am. Oh yeah! Never ridden here before. I think that was 10%. I'm just outside of Barendrecht. Now if I really am doubtful, I can always go to eco mode and humble the last bit. I feel so much more comfortable on the road, even though I probably am supposed to ride there. So yeah, I should be riding here. Alright. He's also telling me that the outside temperature is 9 degrees Celsius. Tunnel! Nothing. Oh yeah, I'm full of motorcycle gear again. I knew it was cold today. I was not sure where my rain pants were, my waterproof rain pants. So I decided, fuck it, motorcycle pants. And now, if you do motorcycle pants, fuck it, motorcycle boots. Oh, I'm not allowed to drive here anymore. We aren't. But you know what, I will take my summer gloves because I like them. They sit comfortable. and I'm not going that fast, so it wouldn't be that cold. I did not anticipate it would be 9 degrees Celsius. And there's no wind protection, of course. My XTS guards, so wind protection. So I'm getting cold fingers right now. And I think we are roughly 1/3 of the journey. Second, third would be Hendrook, Ido Ambacht and Zwijndrecht. And then the last 1/3 would be going across Dordrecht to the end destination. And we're only 19%, so it catched up a little bit. I'm not quite sure if I think I have to go on the bicycle lane here, I think. Nope. Whoops. I don't know, man. All those laws, which bicycle you are and are not allowed to go on with a scooter, are very, very integrated here in the Netherlands, I would say. And I don't drive scooter at all. Or hardly at all. Maybe twice a year when I drop my car off for the yearly checkup. I take the scooter from my parents back to my home and then later on back. Or when I have to leave the motorcycle at my parents' home and I will take the scooter from there. Thank you. That's the same route a couple of times, so I know that route. That was my front locking up. But I remembered I needed to go here. So, front can lock up as well. Jesus. The battery should be chargeable from empty, which is probably like 5% or whatever, all the way up to full in roughly 5 hours. Which isn't bad. That's shorter than most working days. So you can charge it within a working day. If your boss allows you to charge it. And also need to find out at work where I can charge it. The fact that my boots are scraping the ground to some corners means I need to put my toes on the pegs in corners. Which is either a sign of low ground clearance or a sign of high cornerability. Come on, you're going 40. I'm catching up. Dude. Honestly. Dude, honestly. Fuck off. This is where then the luxury of this thing comes into play. I may not be allowed to ride here, but faster behind that bloody car. In a nice location like this, I can just do one loop and I'm legal again. At some point, I think I need to take the bicycle lane, but not just yet. Still not yet. Hey, I don't mind. I will go car all the way. Then a saw sign there. That says bicycle lane only. It's a whole experience about me just talking whether or not it's a bicycle lane. Although he tells me, and that's because it's a bicycle, to take down the stairs. That's what he's telling me here, to stop here and take down the stairs down. I'm not gonna take this thing down the stairs. Hell to the F no. Oh, the cornering angles. Look at this, Rossi. Bump. I kind of expected that as well. Those are the terrible bumps there are. I don't even like taking those with a good bike. Oops. Well, this one was to go too slow for me, so that's the main reason I was taking this lane of traffic. But yeah, from here on I kinda need to follow whatever he is telling me. Which is to take a right here. It's better to it's better to use both brakes. Where are we going and why are we braking? No, now I'm limited by other cars. My scooter is limited by cars. Bye bye, motherfuckers. Quick check, nobody there. That is one of the advantages, of course, of a scooter or a motorcycle in a city. You don't have to be stuck behind that type of cars all the time. Interesting to see Dordrecht from a point that I haven't driven yet. Also in a time, like in a moment, I don't normally drive to Dordrecht. Normally on the way to work, I just take the highway. I have a rough idea where I am. Up there is the dyke. He tells me honestly to drive here. Alright. Apparently I'm legal. No, he was telling me to go up that staircase again. I want to say. Oh, you gotta be careful. You cannot make this up, guy. Okay, that's the downside of following a bicycle system and Google Maps. Fuck the grass. Alright, so then I have to go there. Jesus, my man. Because he also tells you to go down there into the residential area and then come back up later again. No! I'm allowed to drive here, so I'm driving here. So I'm gonna end this journey to work here. Thank you for watching it. Hopefully you got something interesting out of it. And I will see you guys in the next one. Oh yeah, also don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, hit the notification bell if you want to know more. Perfect timing as the lights went out.